There's the big beehive and incredible views, pretty steep trail, and we're hoping to do Mount St. Piron and maybe that guy. So let's see how it goes. So pretty soon you come to these waterfalls, and there's the big beehive. Pretty spectacular. So there's the Devil's Thumb. And there's Big Beehive. And look at this place. Great view, but it is. So you can see the trail winding around the lake. And we'll see where it goes from here. So, here's where we go. Kind of cool, the trail's cut right over the rock. An unbelievably nice day today. Okay, getting a little higher. See Devil's Thumb over there. Okay. Big Beehive is over there. Just about at the top of Big Beehive. Cool views. Devil's Thumb. And you can see there's a log, so it's kind of a decommissioned trail. But let's see how far we can get. So moving up, here's a scrambly section. Doesn't look too hard. Check out the path. Getting closer to the top. Boy, look at these views. Better with every step. Looks imposing, but maybe not too bad. So, how's this for a lunchtime view? Not too bad. So, I have to scramble over all these kind of boulders. You can see some faint trails kind of scooting around. Not sure if I need to go that way. I think there's a magical. I just think didn't really read up on that, so I think I'm gonna go around. Okay, so doing a little exploring here, seeing if the back of Lake Angus, seeing if I can find a route up to Nimblock or St. Perron, I believe those are. I think that one's white. So let's see what happens. Immediately blocked by snow and it's pretty melty. I don't think I want to walk in there and get all soaked. I'm going to see if I can skirt around. Okay, so here's a cairn and a faint trail. Looks like it's going up. There's a bit of scrambling and hands on here. And I'll be careful not to get out of my element. Oh, getting a little higher up. I'm making some cairns every now and then. Okay, so that don't lose my way. And pretty nice waterfall over there. Okay, I think I can almost see the top. It's kind of a lot of route finding, but hey, not bad views. So we basically have to climb up all these boulders. Boulders and boulders and more boulders. Getting closer. The views are really, really opening up. Looks like that's the summit over there. Beautiful summit. Summit of St. Perron. Wow, check out the view. This is crazy. Unbelievable views. Off of Mount St. Perron. Go here a little bit. You'll be able to see Chateau down there. And then beautiful Lake Belize. Mount Fairview. Mount Temple. Okay, so after wasting tons of time up here, it's hard to peel myself away from all the views. Heading down, but I'm going down the more traditional way. There's a pretty clear trail here, so I'm gonna follow this all the way down. Looks like you follow all the way down that ridge, which would be nice. The waves don't seem quite a bit more scenic. Wow. Mm-hmm. lot easier to come down that way. There is very easy switchbacks to follow. So I'll look for the start of the trailhead for you, and this is the way to go. If you want an easy ascent, if you want more challenge, back of the lake. So on the way to Little Beehive is the way up St. Perron. I'm getting eaten alive by a mosquito, so gotta end it. See ya.
Here we are on top of Little Beehive.
And a lot of hiking for one day. It was pretty cool. There's Mount St. Perron. I was just recently at the top. So it's pretty awesome to be able to do 4 objectives in one day. Not bad. Check out the view. So coming down, and one last glimpse at the waterfall.